Good morning, brothers and sisters globally. Thank you very much for joining this billion happy life subscribers marathon. We try to do it the day very interesting and to empower ourselves from the beginning of the day with the good vibe of world scriptures. So let's start them reading. Put the chapter cause and effect. The maximum that a person reaps what he has sown, I believe in divine retribution and the doctrine of karma are diverse expressions of a common idea that the world is governed by justice. Religions give various teaching regarding the specific manner in which justice is meted out. Example, through one faith in this life by reincarnation or in the afterlife. It all agree that one way or another justice will be served. It is the inherited in the nature of the universe as designed by a benevolent creator, that good deeds be rewarded and evil deeds punished. This is the principle of cause and effect. The principle of cause and effect bears the same ambitious relationship to ultimate reality as divine law generally. In the Eastern religions, the principle of justice is inherited in the fabric of the cosmos and therefore subordinate to the ultimate goal of liberation. Karma and the wheel of samsara display the operation of cause and effect. Yet these are part of the hellishness of human existence and have nothing to do with the ultimate goal of nirvana and enlightenment, where the cycle of redot is broken. On the other hand, the monotheistic religions portray gods as the divine judge who visits punishments upon the guilty to maintain justice. Nevertheless, it is not the Heavenly Father's purpose to act as a judge against his children. Rather, with love and truth, he guides them and on the path to salvation. Therefore, as Father Moon does, we can ascribe God's judgments to the operation of his creation, a cosmos that is designed to administer justice through the operation of cosmic law. The passages in this chapter describe two aspects of cause and effect. First is the aspect of justice. People reap what they sow. Father Moon draw instances of this principle not only in the lives of individuals, but also from the history of nations and races who collectively have committed sins that must be equal. Even thought this world seems to tolerate injustice and permit the wrongs to go punished, scriptures have said that the ultimate individual recompense in the afterlife where he or she is designed either to heaven or hell. Here, Father Moon give a deeper explanation for why sinners are destined for hell, not by the decree of the angelic judge, but the condition they made for themselves during earthly life. Second, there are passages on cause and effect as a universal principle that operate in the growth and completion of all beings. We learn that effect is not separate from the cause, rather they are closely tied together. the core Buddhist doctrine of dependent origination expresses the negative of this idea as ignorance developing through the causal chain to the whole human condition of suffering, dukkha. A Taoist text puts it positively that cause and effect form a circuit, the movement of heaven. Father Moon teaches that God is immanent in the world, working everywhere as the cause and revealing himself in human beings as the effect. Ultimately, God and humans, cause and effect, are to be united as Alpha and Omega through love. We reap the consequences of our actions. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked, for whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. Galatians 6:7. Whatever affliction may visit you is for what your own hands have earned. Quran 42:30. All who take the sword will perish by the sword. Matthew 26:52. Suffering is the offspring of the violence. Realize this in and be ever vigilant. Akaraga Sutra 3:13 Janice. Ashes fly back in the face of him who thrones them. Yoruba proverb, African traditional religion. They sow that the wind and they will reap the whirlwind. Hosea 8:7. An ignorant man committing evil deeds does not realize the consequences. The imprudent man is consumed by his own deeds, like the burned by fire. Dahar Mapada 136 Buddhist. Unto God belongs the sequel of all things. Quran 31:22. God is not hornless. He is a horned. He exact punishment for every deed. Ovambo, proverb, African traditional religion. Unrighteousness practiced in this world does not at once produce its fruit, but like a cow advancing slowly, it cuts off the root of him who committed it. Laws of Manu 4:172 Hinduism. There are no special doors for calamity and happiness in man's lot. They come as men themselves call them. Their recompenses follow good and evil as the shadow follow the substance. Trader and response and the retribution one, Taoism. Not in the sky, nor in the mid of the ocean, nor in the mountain cave, it's found that place on earth where abiding one may escape from the consequences of one's evil deed. Dham Pada 127 Buddhist. The net of heaven is cast wide. Though the mesh is not fine, yet nothing ever slips through. The Tao Te Ching 73,000. Below, never average yourself, but leave it to the wrath of God, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. Romans 12:19. Let not their conduct grieve you, who run easily to the disbelief for law. They endure God not at all. It is God God's will to assign them no portion in the hereafter, and there will be an awful doom. And let not those who disbelieve image that the rain we give them bodies doing good for their souls. We only give them rain that they may grow in sinfulness, and they will be a shameful doom. Quran 3, 176, 178. Everything is given on pledge, and the net is spread for all the living. The shop is open, and the dealer gives credit, and the leader lies open, and the hand writes, and whosoever wishes to borrow may come and borrow, but the collectors regularly make their daily round and exact payment from man, whether he be content or not, and they have a debt whereon they can rely in their demand, and the judgment is a judgment of truth, and everything is prepared for the feast. Mashat Avot 3:20 in Judaism. Father, as heaven and earth are the greatest of things, it is the natural from the point of view of universal principles that they have spiritual power. Having spiritual power, it is proper that they reward good and punish evil. Nevertheless, their expanse is great and their net is wide meshed. There is not necessary an immediate response as soon as this net is set in operation. Power 10 Taoises. And further, holy then did I recognize thee, O wise Lord. I perceived three foremost at the birth of life, when thou didst and thou acts and words with retribution, bad unto bad, good blessing unto holy. And through this wisdom at the final goal of life. Avesta Yasha 43:5, Zoroastrianism. According as one act, according as one conducted himself, so thus he became the door of good became good, the door of evil became evil. The one became virtuous by virtuous action, bad by bad action. But people say a person is made not of act, but of desire only. I say, as his desire, such is his resolve. As is his resolve, such the action he performs, what action he performs, and that he procures for himself. On this point, there this verse, where one mind is attacked, the inner self goes peripheral action, being attached to its one, obtaining the end of his action. Whatever he does in this world, he became again from that world, so this world of action. So the mind that desire. Bahadari Haika Upanishad 4, 4, 5, 6 Hinduism. And further, let's read the Second Coming Messiah teaching of Sun, Moon, Moon. In order to, for life to be sustained, centering on his body, all the different parts must engage and give and take action as subject and object partners. Is everything engaged in this action? Does what it is supposed to do, then the physical body will function smoothly and the existence will continue. But what happens when this is blocked somewhere? This universe protects anything that engages and gives and take action with God's ideal. If an opposing element appears, something becomes lacking or there is a blockage, there will be a failure with that realm of interaction. Hence, in order to protect the universe, there will be a reaction to expel it. This reaction is not a bad thing. It may be seen as something bad, but is truly functioning to protect the larger realm. For example, if your stomach hurts, it means there is a blockage in a circuit of give and take action between some subject and object partner. The blockage causes it to be pushed away to the same extent as it is blocked. A cosmic force to push it out act on the stomach and it hurts. All you need to do is open the place that is blocked and you will feel fine. Likewise, the world of our conscience and the entire human world are in pain. Why? There are elements that do not meet the standard of the cosmic force and the universe is trying to push them out. Hence, we feel pain in our conscience. While the conscience was going in the proper direction, something stood opposing it and blocked the conscience function. We experience a reaction resulting in pain. If the problem is not solved, that reaction will send the person into hell. The law of cause and effect cannot be avoided. In history, America is an extension of a Great Britain. Thus, America is in a position to identify that Britain did wrong in history. What did Britain do when she colonized Asia, especially China? She killed countless Asians through pushing the opium trade. Britain adopted the policy to dominate the Chinese and the profit of them, while totally unconcerned that the whole population became helpless addict. Someone today has to indemnify that sin. Americans, especially American youth, should identify that historical debt. Otherwise, young people here will be plagued by drugs as a result. God abhors sin in the misuse of love is the sin God abhors the most. God regards sinners who commit such a transgression and do not repent as his enemies, and he visits them with destruction. It is the principle that wherever indulgent in illicit love will perish. In Italy, the lustful and immoral city of Pompeii was destroyed by instant calamity. Sodom and Gomorrah perished under the same law. The Roman Empire once prevailed in the world with unparalleled power, but it collapsed for the same reason. From the vantage point of history, America today is on the same path, unless it repents for its violation of the law of God's love, it too will perish. I was involved in the underground resistance movement against Japanese imperial rule, and from this perspective, the Japanese were my enemies. They were the enemies of the Korean people in the general and my enemies in particular. Yet after Japan was defeated at the end of World War II, I loved the Japanese. Some time earlier, certain Japanese policemen had arrested me for my activities in the resistance and tortured me severely. When the war ended, I could have reported them and they all would have been executed. Yet when I came across those same policemen running for their lives, I helped them escape to safety. Do not know why so many young people in Japan placed their eternal lives in my hands and pledged their loyalty to me. it is because there is a principle of cause and effect, which dictate that they must return what was given. Yes, so interesting, brothers and sisters, let's read further God's Global Trends book, God's Network. We see from history that deeper the people hide God, the more terrible things they done. However, everyone thinking of him, although all people try to hide this connection as much as possible for now, nowadays it is vital important to break this silence. Humankind need to unite and develop a global network of lovers of God, our heavenly parent. That's the most fashionable thing to do these days. We all humankind are this God's global temple. Whether we want it or not, we are all interconnected in God's network with each other and with an ancestor and the ancestors with the descendants. Therefore, the mistake of one directly affects their relatives and the whole humanity eventually. We need to gradually develop God's network in this era of instant communication technology. You should not hesitate to share your story about God. I personally went to 30 countries and visited many churches and faiths. There are also interviewing people, some days meeting thousands of people per day, and by this I find out different sides of God. I do find God in all people around. Truly, if you want to understand God as a parent, ask, speak with his children. However, I don't meet anybody who in very difficult situation doesn't pray in one way or another. Usually we are so busy in daily routine that we don't find time for prayer. So why not change it and do it vice versa? Just pray joyfully ahead for good things to happen and to prevent bad things. There are many traps in relationship with the people around. Some as usual, some are on time and life, but the key for it is simple. You must really love the people you meet because they are in the temples of God. Therefore, all people are connected in a God's interdependent network. Also, this is networking us with an ancestors and the future generation too. It's a pity that currently in this network, many times we modern humans still relate with each other as a kid in kindergarten, or sometimes even worse, fighting as a hothead youth at the disco. Especially this kind of relationship is used a lot by politicians and even president globally, as we see in their news. Business use this for concurrent to fight, so unfortunately for now, this network is dysfunction. We cannot properly build cooperative horizontal relationship with one another because our vertical relationship with God have been severed and we perform deeds harmful to others because we cannot feel the pain and suffering of our neighbor as our own. Happily, thanks God, during the history, this network is rebuilt step by step. And now it attained its final stage toward perfection. See my other book, Humankind on its Final Step to Perfection. Humans are unhappy without God. Therefore, nowadays social networks are so popular, people try to connect to each other and reconnect back to God. Yes, this is, brother and sister, the message for today. So interesting. Words for to empower us. So please take this and practice it today and remember it every hour. Some words that touch you, and you will have a good goals and vision, and you could do it better and achieve greater results because you are with God. So as we read, don't hide God and this relationship. And of give and take, just what you give goodness that you will receive. Please join this billion happy life subscribers, subscribe this this video and share it with all your friends to get billion people with this great news of the second coming Messiah. Have a great day and don't forget to make morning exercise. Bye bye, see you tomorrow.